Hi, everyone. It's great to be at this Computex. I'm Ali Kani, Vice President and General Manager of NVIDIA's automotive business. AI is the most powerful technology force of our time, and it's transforming virtually every industry, from healthcare to finance to manufacturing. I'm here today to talk about autonomous vehicles. It's perhaps the most intense AI challenge, but also one with the greatest impact. The transportation industry is incredibly large at $10 trillion. It includes not just passenger vehicles, but also taxis, delivery vans, commercial trucks, and even specialized vehicles like tractors. This industry is going through a major transformation. In the past, vehicles were defined by their driving experience. A key capability of a vehicle used to be its horsepower. Today, I'm going to speak about how advancements in deep learning and robotics technologies are redefining the industry based on a vehicle's computing capability. Eventually, this entire industry will be autonomous, and it will take many, many billions of dollars to develop. The mission of the NVIDIA Drive AV team is to develop this self-driving technology to help our partners bring this technology to market. Now, I want to spend some time talking about how challenging it is to develop self-driving cars. First, you need a high-performance computer architecture and sensor set in the car that's capable to deliver a safe driving experience. Second, you need to ingest many petabytes of data a day, safely encode and secure it, and then send it to the cloud to then curate, label, and identify every object, road user, and traffic sign. After all this data is processed, we need to train AI networks on this really large data set. These AI models then must also be validated on many thousands of hours of data to guarantee safe performance. And finally, to further increase the range of possible scenarios for testing and optimization, we rely heavily on simulation. Simulation allows us to run the AV technology through rare and difficult scenarios in a scalable, physically accurate, and efficient manner. Now, all of these reasons is why NVIDIA is building our AV platform end-to-end. From AV chips and computers, sensor architecture, data processing, AV perception and mapping software, to the infrastructure where we do the training and create the simulated digital twin, to fleet command and the operation center where we can remotely operate your fleet, finally to road testing. NVIDIA is building this entire platform to the highest functional safety and cybersecurity standards. And we're building this platform in modules, so our partners in the $10 trillion transportation industry can take what they need. Since AV is such a grand challenge and will take years to develop, we believe what differentiates AV excellence more than anything else is the speed of this development flow. The companies with the best development flow will be the most successful AV companies. And we believe this because the AV development process is continuously improving as we still have much work to do. AI-powered vehicles will continue to get smarter and smarter over time as the software is trained for new tasks, enhanced, tested, and validated. And then finally, that software will be updated over the air into your vehicle. Now, one of the key modules in our AV platform is the perception layer, where the autonomous vehicle sees everything on the road just like a human driver would. In total, you need more than 20 AI models to take a vehicle to production. First, you need some models that help you see objects like vehicles, bicycles, pedestrians, and even road debris. You also need networks to help you see lanes and to compute the best path to take when dealing with merges and splits. Third, you need models to understand urban scenarios like intersections, traffic lights. You even need networks to understand the gestures from people on the street. Since AV is developed to provide a redundant coverage for safety, we build networks that not only run on the camera sensors in your vehicle, but we also have object detection networks that run on radar and LiDAR to provide a redundant detection to ensure a vehicle does not contribute to an accident. Now, once you have great perception software, you can perceive lanes, signs, poles, and lights, which you can then use to build a high-quality driving map. This generated high-definition map is also kept fresh because an autonomous vehicle is always learning. So Drive AV dynamically can update maps after any vehicle in an OEM fleet drives the same route again. The final core component of AV is the driving or motion planning application. Once you have high-quality perception and mapping software, the autonomous vehicle needs to decide how to drive and navigate to a passenger's target route. This motion planning layer needs to be very advanced. This is why NVIDIA has created the Safety Force Field, which analyzes and predicts the dynamics of the surrounding environment by taking in sensor data and determining a set of actions to protect the vehicle and other road users. The SFF framework ensures these actions will never create, escalate, or contribute to an unsafe situation, and includes actions necessary to mitigate potential danger. Having a robust AV validation strategy is critical to make sure an AV is safe. Of course, we need to test AVs on the road, but it's really hard to experience all the corner case situations that happen in the real world. This is why we also need to test AV in simulation, and why NVIDIA has built our own simulation platform based on Omniverse that creates a physically accurate base simulator of the real world. It's called DriveSim, only with a combination of on-road testing and its simulated digital twin can you really make sure an AV vehicle is ready to safely drive. Now let me show you what DriveSim software based on Omniverse lets you do in this video. As NVIDIA announced last year, we are partnering with Mercedes-Benz to deliver an AV platform to their fleet of vehicles starting in 2024. This video shows you the early results of our collaboration, which starts with a development flow that lets you first develop AV software in a physically accurate simulator that is essentially identical to a real car. In this video, you can see that we've modeled a Mercedes-Benz EQS to be true to life. It has accurate vehicle shape and dimensions, true to life vehicle dynamics, including the vehicle's tires, and the acceleration of the car is physically accurate. And of course, we have modeled the accurate sensor models and are running AV software on an identical computer architecture in the cloud. After building this digital twin car, we're able to simulate AV software running on Daimler's vehicle, and we can run different traffic and weather models to test the robustness of AV really quickly this way. We're very proud of this video because we can get AV running on a new sensor set and a new car in just a few months. By having a physically accurate drive simulator, I hope this video shows you how you can speed development by letting developers first test in sim and then test in the real world. Since AV is such a large investment, NVIDIA offers an architecturally compatible hardware lineup that provides attractive price performance across the entire AV stack. This spans from entry ADAS computer at 10 TOPS and 6 watts to a full self-driving solution that needs more than 2,000 TOPS. We built this end-to-end lineup to allow OEMs to leverage a single architecture across their fleet of vehicles. We still have some partners that build their fleet with different computers and sensor set across a few of their models, and we're happy to support them this way. The auto industry is going through a change similar to the phone industry. There was a time that Apple's value was based on the number of phones it sold a year. Today, they sell close to $200 million a year. But the industry realized a few years ago that the value of Apple is in its installed base of phones, which is in the billions of phones. And the key is, what's the value of services that they provision over this installed base? Apple now generates $75 billion a year of services on their installed base. This is why Apple puts the highest performing chips into their phones, so they have room to provide new services over the life of that phone. Tesla has created the same paradigm in auto. They ship a high performance computer and full sensor set in every vehicle, and they are now selling their AV service at $10,000 a car. This is really great and transformative for the industry, as it enables a fundamentally new business model not possible before. We are now seeing startups build electric vehicles that are disrupting the auto industry. Rather than just being great at auto manufacturing, they've learned from Apple. Fundamentally, their technology companies focused on building software-defined cars with a computing service business model that they can amortize over the life of their vehicles. A lot of the exciting work in this industry is being led in the Asia-Pacific region, with really fast-moving and exciting companies building disruptive cars from companies such as NIO, XPeng, Li Auto, and SAIC. There are also exciting companies that are trying to turn the taxi industry into a service now. What's really exciting about this market is that vehicles with full self-driving are using computers that include not just our SoCs, but they also use our Ampere architecture discrete GPUs. While an L2 autonomous vehicle might need a few cameras and radar and run on a 200-top computer, a fully self-driving vehicle could need more than 20 cameras, 20 radar, and even use 10 LiDAR. This type of vehicle can need more than 2,000 TOPS of performance. What I'm most proud of is the size of NVIDIA's ecosystem. There are hundreds of companies that are developing applications on our Drive platform today. Some are building software that can get deployed on OEM vehicles. Others are actually OEMs that are building their full L2 driving application. Some are building L4 commercial trucking products. Others are building L5 robotaxi. We build our platform to be modular so our customers can build the best product that fits their needs. I want to thank you very much for joining me. It was a pleasure to get to talk to you today. Hopefully next year I can see you all in person. Thank you. Thank you.